Sir, there is a share option besides, wait, let me make you the presenter first. Beside the mic, there is a share now option. You can press that and share your screen. Camera ka icon is there, and then mic ka icon is there, and then share now icon is there.
Now is it visible?
Yes, it is visible.
Good morning, everyone. Sorry for the delay.
So, okay. We start with the last day of the FDP, that is 14th of January, and we have Dr. Arvind Pandey with us. He's the head department of data science and analytics at Central University of Rajasthan. Welcome you, sir. You can start the session.
Thank you. Okay, so today I am going to discuss with the survivor analysis issue. So basically, why we are need a survivor analysis and where we are going to use it. I am giving very simple example starting from this one. Today, this morning, I started to try to connect with you, but it takes some time. Okay. Suppose if you try, several people start try to connect on the same software to the same audience, but different people are taking the different times. So this time interval is important. So if you want to study of this type of interval, then we can use the survivor analysis. So now we are coming to the first, what is the survivor analysis? So survivor analysis is generally defined as the set of the method for analyzing data where the outcomes variable in the time until the occurrence of the event. Ab dhyan se samjhiye. Is morning mein kya kiya? Maine subah se system, I just want to join with you. But it takes 12 to 15 minute time. Some students join this meeting only in 2 minutes. Some take the 5 minutes, some take the 15 minutes. And I took approximately 20 minutes. So I joined the meeting, event is happened, but time is different for every people. Suppose there is 50 people in this meeting and every people is took different time. So event is happened, but we are interested in the how much time is required to happen in that event. So the event can be death, occurrence of the disease, marriage, divorce, anything in a similar way. The time of the event of the survivor analysis can be measured in the days, weeks, years, or seconds, or anything. Whatever unit you want, you can measure it. Whenever we are talking about the survivor analysis, we are all having a feeling that we are talking about the survival of a person or survival of a human being or survival of a living thing. No, it is not related to the death or something or like that. It is related to the every event for occurrence of that event. You are interested in the time interval, how much time is required for that a particular event. So when we are talking about the time, so time is varying for individual to individual, system to system. So this occurrence of time is going to be a random phenomenon. So when it is a random quantity, then we can apply our statistical tools to get our results, and then we can just go. First question is that what is the time? The time we mean years, months, weeks, or days from the beginning of the follow-up of an individual until an event. Okay. So time is of any quantity that may be year, month, week, days, hours, minutes, seconds, or anything that can be you have to use to track your event. Alternatively, time can be referred to the age of the individual when an event is occurred. Okay. By event, we means birth, disease incident, relapse for some remission, recovery, example, return to the work, or any desired experience of the interest that may be happened to the individuals. Okay, suppose I am talking about the all of you are the students pass your option. So when you get your job, so we are interested in the two things: at what age you get the job, first thing, and what is the difference between your past degree and getting the job. So sometime when we are talking about this, at which age you get the job, someone is get the job at 23, someone get the job at 24, someone get the job at 25, that is not much relevant. But when we are talking about the when you are finish your final degree and you get a job, that may be a 0 month, because someone get the campus placement, someone is getting the after 2 months, someone is have to wait for 1 year, someone is have to wait for the 3 years. So this type of event, for the same event, we can get a different type of data, and those data, one of them is so much of interest, another is very less interest. Suppose when I'm talking about the when you are getting the job at 24, 25 or 26 or 21, that is not of much importance. But we are much more interested in the after finishing your last graduation or PG or anything else, for on which basis of which degree you are getting the job. From there to getting a job is an important thing. Means when I finish my PhD, so after finishing my PhD, how much time is required or how much time I have to wait get a job. Okay, so it is varying from different to different. Suppose someone is person get married, so marriage is that nowadays you are at a particular age, you are eligible of getting married legally. So after that you can get a marriage, but you are not going to get married on the same day, next day. You are getting married after 5 years, 3 years, 2 years, 10 years, and some people are getting after 10 years. So this duration after eligibility, you are getting married. So by this one, we can get the pattern or behavior in the society that how much people are waiting for the marriage, and after this time, they are getting the marriage. Now we are interested, suppose, in the divorce. So divorce is a quantity that when you get the marriage, after how much time you get go ahead, and then you get the things. Suppose there is some disease out there. So some people are getting some disease. Now we are interested in when they are going to get cured. So suppose someone is having this cough and cold is the combination and someone is suffering from this one. How much time is required to be cured? It may be 1 days, it may be 3 days, it may be 5 days, it may be 7 days, and some people take 10 days. First question is that same fever, same type of fever, why taking different times for the different individuals? There is one question. Now, again, we are coming to the time, then after that, one thing is the time. Time is required corresponding to an event. So then what is, which type of event? So the event interest of the any event for which we are interested. So for example, we are supposed interested in the heart attack, when the survival time can be time in the years until a person developed a heart attack. Ab dhyan se suniye. When we are talking about the heart attack, first time of interest can be the at what age that person get a first heart attack. Or second point of interest can be that how much time person survive after the first heart attack. Some people are died in the first heart attack. Some people can survive for the second or third of and up to 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, or 3 years, 10 years, or 15 years. So we are interested in the time some event has happened, and then we are trying to model the time. So when we have an idea about the time, then we have to go this way. So lifetime of the individuals, components, systems, etc. are unpredictable and random, and hence, now we are apply the probabilistic and statistical law. So you can apply the probability and statistical law only in those conditions where your phenomena is random. If things is not random, it is deterministic, there is no need to apply the statistics, just go by the mathematics. I am giving a very simple example. If I am saying that you have to maintain 10 kilometers per hour speed and you have to move for the 7 hours. So 10 hour per kilometer and you have to continue for the 7 hours. So you should be at exactly 70 kilometers you should travel. But what happened? When you practically try to maintain, you cannot maintain exactly 70. On average, you can maintain the 70. And after 7 hours, when you reach the point that may be somewhere more than 69 and less than 71, but it is not going to be exact 70. So this randomness is required when in real life we are getting the randomness. When you're talking to the mathematics people, they will tell that, okay, no problem. When you talk moving with a speed of 10 hours per kilometer for 7 hours, it is a 70 kilometers, no problem. But when you talk to the statistician, he will tell us, no. You are going to somewhere between 69 to 71. I am sure that you are going to lie between this one. So in a practical, it is more useful information that you are going to finish between this to this. So whenever there is randomness, you can use the statistical method and probability methods and then just go ahead. Okay, now, next thing. Censoring is one of the most important thing in the survival analysis, and it has happened almost second, third, or it is very frequent phenomenon in the survival analysis. So I'm giving with one example. Suppose you are staying in a particular community and there is a doctor and several people are suffering from the fever. They went to the doctor and took the medicine and come back. After return, they are again visit the doctor for the follow-up. So after 3 days to 4 days, some people came back, tell that, sir, I just got cured in 2 days. I have no problems. Doctor, okay, no problem. No need to take the medicine. Some people, he asked that, okay, you have to take the medicine for the 1 more days or 2 more days. And out of, suppose, 10 persons are visited first time, now there is only 7 or 6 is turned up. So when 7 or 6 is turned up, what happened to the others? So doctor has a information about the only 7 people, not about the other 3 people. What is the possible reason? It may happen that out of 3, those people get cured very early. They have no problem. So they are not come back to the doctor. Second, they are have some more problems, so they change the doctor. So there is for the remaining 3 people or 4 people, doctor have no information. But actually what happened? Doctor knows that I given the medicine on that day and they are get the medicine and I have no idea. But after 4 days, doctor tells that all the patient that you have to come back for the after 3 days. So those people are cured before 4 days. They are not going to come back. Doctors knows that these people are get cured in the 2 days or 3 days. For those people out of, suppose 5 people are, they have to come back. So out of 5, only 3 is come back. So now doctor knows that these 3 are get cured, but remaining 2 people are not cured up to the 4th day and they are missing. So these type of things are very common phenomena in the survival analysis and we are calling it the censoring. So most survival analysis must consider a key analytical problem called censoring. In instance, censoring occurs when we have some information about the individual survival time, but we don't know the survival time exactly. So doctors is having the information that they are not cured up to the 5th day, but after that, if people are not come back, he has no idea that what has happened to them. Okay, suppose some people are suffering from the cancer. It happens that in the cancer cases, people are just cured, and after that, they are coming for the follow-up. They are coming for the follow-up for the several years. It means maybe 10 years or something. So some of them are coming up to 10 years. Some are not coming after 4 years. Some are is not coming after 10 years. So whenever up to this point, doctor have information that that person is alive, means death has not occurred, then they have information, but they are alive or not. If someone is not coming for the follow-up, doctor cannot claim that that person is alive or he is dead. So now situation is that doctor have some information that that person was alive up to that time. After that, he has no information. So when we are talking about the censoring, there are a different type of censoring. So first question is that why censor? So there are three reasons are main. Study ends. So when you, whatever you are doing, your study can be end. Lost of the follow-up and withdraws. Suppose I am giving a question paper to solve you, and I am giving that you have to solve the question paper in 20 minutes. My interest of the event is how much time is required to solve the paper. Some students can solve the question paper in less than 20 minutes. Someone can get this question paper in the 19, 20 minutes. And some people submit the question paper at the 20 minutes, but questions are not complete. Okay, so in this situation, study ends and they have not completed the paper. So it is the one reason of the censoring. Last of the follow-up. Last of the follow-up is that I just collecting the paper, and after 15 minutes or something, I just tell that, okay, I have some other work, so I am just going, leaving now. So what I did, I just leave the experiment hall or the room. So I have no idea that after 15 minutes what has happened. Then there is withdrawals. Some students are giving the exam, and after that they are saying that, no sir, we are not interested in giving the exam. So they just leave the room, and then there is a withdrawal. So this type of things are very
important.
Hello.
Priyan, batao.
Hello. Any questions? Okay. So no questions. That's why I'm just going ahead. Suppose you are talking about the clinical trials. Some medicines you are trying to get verified, and there is a clinical trials in running. So clinical trials are running for a particular period. So when the event is occurred, then it is okay. If event is not occurred, then you are saying that no problem. So then you are going to get the sensor data. Last of the follow-up. Suppose some patients are going home and then they are not coming back, then there you have a problem. Suppose after certain period of time, some patient is saying that, no, sir, I am not interested. Suppose there is one particular death is occurred in during the that your trial. So what happened? There will be panic situations. Some patients may say that, sir, I am not interested. I just want to go back. So then you have to allow them. So if you are allowing them, then what happened? You are lost a patient, but you have information that that person is alive up to that. So there is one more situation is that suppose some people are suffering from a particular disease, and you are trying to follow that person is how much time he is going to survive from that disease. But that person is passed away due to some other disease. Suppose tuberculosis and asthma. This tuberculosis and asthma are the two diseases which occur generally together. So if you are interested in the tuberculosis and patient is passed away due to asthma, then you know that person is alive up to that time. He was not died, but for you, that is a censored observation. So when you are getting the censored observation, that is the one of the most common problem in the survival analysis. So now, so why we are coming for the censoring? The person does not experience the events before the study ends, first one. The person has lost the follow-up during the study, it is second one. A person withdraw from the study because of the death. If death is not event of the interest or some other reasons, example, adverse drug reaction or any other competing risk. So when I am talking about the first example, I talk that some people are withdrawn, they are due to some adverse drug effect, or when we are talking about the two or more disease and someone is died from some other disease in which we are not interested, that disease is, this type of events are known as the competing risk. Okay. Visual representation is here. Suppose I just started the experiment A, B, C, D, E, and F. There is six people are interested in the study. And for the person A, for the T is equal to 5, for 5 at the time unit of 5 week, this event is occurred. Then for B, whole period of the study is 12 week, it is continue and there is no result. Someone is entered the study in somewhere between 2 and 3 weeks. but he continued for 3.5 weeks and then he withdraw. Then again some people's person started and he continue up to the end of the study. Then some people is this one entered in somewhere up to 6 units of the week and then he is lost. So then t is equal to 3.5 times and the event is happened. Now see, so this is, there is 6 persons. In out of 6, 2 persons are giving the event, or they feel the event, or they pass through the events. What about the others 4? This person completed the study, but he did not experience the event. This D is also completed the study, but he did not experience the event. So it is a censored observation. We know this person is survived for 12 weeks, this person is survived for the 8 weeks, and event is not happened. This person is withdrawn and this person is lost. Someone is lost or someone is a withdrawn for the statistician, both are the censored data. If you are not accorded it, experienced the event and you completed the whole study period, even then you are a censored data. So for us, B, C, D and E, these 4 are the censored data. And this one, it is a 3 different type of reasons by which you are getting the censored data. Okay, so now see, for person A, survival time is 5. For person B, survival time is 12. For person C, survival time is 3.5. For person D, it is 8. For person E, 6. Person F, 3.5. So now, failed is 1, censored is 0. So you are getting only A and D, failed, and others are not. So others are just for the censored observations. Okay. So now, when we are talking about the censoring, we are talking about the censoring. Censoring is the basically 3 type of, and there is some other type of also there, but we are going to discuss only 3 basic types. So first time we are going to use the word right censored. Right censored means those observations are started to a particular time, and we are knowing that up to a particular time this event does not happen, and after that we have no idea. Means from the right side portion we have no idea, then we are saying that it is a right censored. So in real life most of the time we are facing the right censored. Okay. So this right censored, I suppose you have started the experiment, you finish the experiment, but if you have no idea about the what is happened with that person, or that is survived, or something, that event is occurred or not, then it is a right censored. Then we are talking about the left censored. Left censored data is that you know some event has happened, you know it happened is at a particular time t, but you have no idea when it is started. Suppose a person is tested HIV positive. So if someone is tested and he's got the HIV positive, means he is having HIV infection in his body developed to some time, but you have no idea when it is developed. But you are knowing that it is tested positive at this time t, but event is already happened. You are testing. Because of you are tested that he is positive, he is not infected. He had an infection and you are testing for some other reasons and you found that it is present there. So some event is already happened. You have no idea. But when you check or in the surveillance or something, then you find that this is happened. Okay. So this type of data is not censored. Okay. Then there is interval censoring. Sorry, first one is known as a left sensor data. Then we are talking about the interval censoring. So in interval censoring is that you have information that event is happened. It is happened between time T1 and time T2, but you don't have an idea that when it is happened. Same HIV case, I am telling that you did the test for a particular person, found that they get it. You show that at time T1 there is no damage. After some years, he again tested and he found that he is positive. When he is found that positive, means event has happened. And you are sure that this event has not happened to T1. So now, situation is that your event has happened this T1 to between T1 and T2. In the lesson, it can happen at any time from the zero to this one. You are sure that it is going to happen. Sorry, it was happened in somewhere T1 to T2. So this white type of answering is known as the data can occur when a person true survival time is less than or equal. Interval sensing actually incorporate both right sensing and left sensing as a special case. Left sensor data occurs when value of T1 is zero and T2 is known as a upper bound on the true survival time. Okay, aise dhyan do. Agar is T1 ko hum zero kar denge, then it is a left sensor. And if we are not talking about T2, we are only talking about the table, then it is a right sensor. Okay. So in this one, what we are getting random? Random T is a survival time. Survival time we are getting is a random phenomenon. So for the notations, we are going to use capital T as a survival time. That quantity T is going to always greater than or equal to zero. That is going to be random variable, and small t is for t. For example, t is greater than small t. Okay. Now there we are going to introduce another random variable. T is equal to zero or one. Defined variable. Sorry, it is not random variable. Yeah, it is random variable. D zero comma one. It is equal to one. If it is failed, it is equal to zero. It is so corresponding to any particular unit or any particular system or any particular belong human being or living thing, some phenomena is happened, then we are taking it is a one, it is equal to zero. Remember, whenever we are talking about survival analysis, failure does not mean that failure means your event is happened. That may be a positive thing, that may be for both we are going to tell that failure is okay. Now, so we are defining two things, ST is the survivor function and ST is the hazard function. So just see here, this quantity T, it is survive is greater than this quantity. So we are from this one, we are going to define as this quantity survivor function. Basically ST is equal to probability of capital T is greater than T. So for T is equal to 1, ST, S1, we write down probability of T is greater than 1. For T is equal to 2, S2, we write down the meaning of this one, probability of T is greater than 2. S3 is equal to probability of T is greater than 3. So now we are talking about the survival functions. First is that ST and another is HT. So survival function ST gives the probability that a person survives longer than some specific time, specified time T. So means suppose I am talking about the someone is getting cured from a flu or corona infection after 3 days. So what is the probability that he will be fit after 3 days? So probability of that random variable T is going to get a value greater than T, or T is equal to 3 or something. Then hazard rate. Hazard Hello.
Yes sir.
यहाँ सब गायब हो गया है, मेरी स्क्रीन गायब हो गई, मेरी स्क्रीन दिख रही है वहाँ?
नहीं सर, आपकी स्क्रीन पे प्रेजेंटेशन नहीं दिख रही है, स्क्रीन तो दिख रही है।
तो ये मैं कहां से आ जाऊं फिर?
आप इसको मिनिमाइज करिए ना, अपनी स्क्रीन डिसमिस नहीं करिए, मिनिमाइज करिए। हाँ, अब दिख गया, दिख गया।
ओके ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम, ओके, थैंक यू, जस्ट वन मिनट। सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट आफ्टर दैट द हैजार्ड रेट। बेसिकली हैजार्ड रेट इज बेसिकली इंस्टेंटेनियस फेल्योर रेट, giving that your item is survived up to a time t. See, just try to understand both thing. ST is talking about that your probability of any particular event happened after a time t. Okay, so that t can be happened from that point to up to infinity, survive. Then hazard function is a conditional failure rate, that talking about the probability of happening any event or failure or something, you know it is not happened up to time t, but is going to happen in the next delta t time, and that delta t goes to zero. Means you are knowing your thing is not happened up to this time, but in the next moment it is going to happen. So this rate is hazard rate. Okay, so now first we discuss about the survival function. I think all of you, when you use the distribution, I think all of you studied some distribution functions, probability distributions in the previous seminar, and I think in this one also. So when you write down the survival function and plot it, theoretically, suppose it is survival function of this exponential distribution, for example. So when you plot the survival function, you are going to get this type of thing, very smooth, and this will be, as this goes to infinity, that will goes to zero. But when you go really in the practice for the real data, when you calculate ST hat, it is theoretical, it is a function, and it is an estimated survival function. When you write down the estimated survival function, you are going to get a step functions. Okay, and now if your data is coming from this distribution, this line and this step function should be very close to each other. Okay. So what is the property of the ST? So ST is a non-decreasing function with respect to T. Sorry, non-increasing function. It is a non-increasing function, means that function cannot increase. At T is equal to zero, ST is equal to 0, it should be 1. And when put T is equal to infinity, this should be equal to 0. So now, whenever you use any survival function, it may be from the variable, it may be from the gamma, it may be from the exponential, it may be from the log normal, it may be from the Pareto, it may be from the beta, or any other distributions. So your survival function is going to follow this property. When you put t is equal to 0, you will get the value is equal to 1. And when you put value t is equal to infinity, you are going to get the value 0. And always remember, ST is a non-increasing function. So this function can be a constant up to some time, then after that it will be increased. Whatever the situation, this one is not going to increase. If t1 is greater than t2, so S of T1 always going to less than the S of T2. Okay, now we are coming to the hazard function. I am defining the hazard function is denoted by the ST, is given by the formula ST equals to the limit as delta T approaches to zero of a probability statement about the survival divided by delta T, where delta T denotes a small interval of the time. So HT is equal to limit delta T goes to zero, probability of T is capital T is greater than small t but less than t plus delta t, given that t is greater than or equal to t, in divided by this one. When you're talking about this quantity, numerator, this quantity, basically this is what it is. It is a conditional probability. Conditional probability that your event is probability of t is greater than or equal to t, and then this t is happening greater than t but less than t plus delta t. And this delta T is going to goes to zero. Okay, so basically this upper portion is a conditional probability, and when you combine this one, basically it is a rate of failure. So sometimes we are calling HT the instantaneous failure rate. Okay, so when we are talking about the instantaneous failure rate, so rate can be anything. So HT is going to be always greater than zero, and this one can goes up to infinity. So your survival function HT always going to lies between 0 and 1, and your HT can be starting from 0 to infinity. However, the hazard function is also of the interest of the following reasons. It is a measure of the instantaneous potential where a survival curve is a cumulative measure over time. It may be used to identify a specified model for such as exponential, Weber, log, normal curves and fit one of the data. It is the vehicle by which mathematical modeling of the survival data is carried out. That is, the survival model is usually written in the terms of the hazard function. We are talking ST and HT. In survival analysis, it does not make any difference that you are talking about ST or you are talking about HT. If you know any one of them, you can conclude or discuss or find each and every results. Okay, so HT and HT, both are the, by using both, you can find anything, but both are the totally opposite nature. When we just go ahead, see, HT is instantaneous potential. See, what is the focus? HT is more talking about the not failing. HT is talking about the not failing survival. We are talking that unit will be survive greater than T. And HT, we are talking about the failing, that is the instantaneous failure rate. So we are talking about the two opposite concepts at the same time, and then I am claiming that the both are the equivalent. Not equivalent, they can be used to find a solution of the same problem. So HT is not failing and HT is failing. Suppose ek pe hum baat kar rahe hain ki ye fail ho jayega, dusra kar raha hai nahi fail karega, aur do alag cheezon ka hum use kar rahe hain same problem ko solve karne ke liye. Now we are coming to this. So when we are talking about the HT, again I am explaining, try to understand this hazard rate. It is very important thing. So basically it is a conditional probability of A given B. This is a conditional probability. So probability of individual fails in the interval T to T plus delta T survive up to this time. So this portion is numerator and this delta T is a small t and this goes to zero. That gives you a HT. Okay. So now question is that what is the HT? HT is always greater than or equal to zero. HT has no bound. Just try to understand. When I discuss about the HT, I just tell that HT is a non-increasing function. But for the HT, I did not make any statement. When we are talking about this HT can take any shape. It may be simple straight line. It may be straight line up to a point, then it is increasing. It may be a straight line, then decreasing. It may be increasing, it may be decreasing, it may be some other. See, suppose it is this type of shape. I just wait a minute, I just show you some other structures also. My screen is visible. Hello, screen dikh rahi hai?
Yes, it is very much
visible. Yes, sir.
Okay, so now we are talking about the hazard function. See, this is a hazard function. Your hazard, it is a H of T and it is a T. This one. So it is a zero and this T is infinity. So this hazard function can be this one. This can be this one. This can be this one. Even this can be this type of also. This one. This one. This type of different type of hazard function having a different interpretation. Now I am talking about this one. When your hazard function is very much constant, suppose your hazard function is this one. This HT is, sorry, this HT is almost a constant. Suppose C. So when Hazard rate is constant means you are talking about the whatever the time your instantaneous failure rate is same. Means suppose you are talking about a unit. Suppose you purchase a mobile and I am saying that failure of your phone is hazard rate of your phone is constant C. Means what is the probability of that is going to fail is today, that is going to be the same after 2 years, after 10 years and after 15 years. Means I am claiming that there is a no aging effect on your system. When I am talking about the hazard rate of this one, means as you increase the time, your instantaneous failure rate is decreasing, means probability of chances of failure is, what has happened? Instantaneous failure rate is decreasing, means your system is going to more reliable, or you are less chances that you are going to event is happened in the next moment. For example, suppose one marriage has happened. So if divorce is going to happen, that is going to happen in the some beginning of the years. It is very difficult to that you marriage survives for the 35 years and after that you are going to get a divorce. There is a possibility, but it is very less chances. So as time increases, chances of having that event in the next moment is reducing. It is increasing. So something has happened as time of age is increasing, your chances is also increasing, means aging effect is there at time of chances of survival is going to less. Now I just make one interesting graph in, I will make this one. This type of graph is a survival analysis that is very interesting. Most of the people interested in this type of curve because it is has a very particular type of application. Suppose when we are interested in the modeling of the lifetime of the human being. So when you talk about the what is the chances of the failure, suppose someone is born, newborn. Newborn baby have a high mortality rate at the time t is equal to zero. When it is passed to some period of 6 months or something, then it is drastically chances of failure is decreases. Then after 3 to 5 years, it is almost again decreasing. But after 5 years to somewhere, it is 60 years, it is almost a constant. And then after 60 years, it is start increasing. So chances of occurring a death is increasing. So this type of this HT, by using HT, you can explain your phenomena and everything, and that can be used for modeling of the data. Okay. So now it is basically a probability per unit time. So most of the time people are asking in the Viva that it is a probability, why it is not lies between 0 and 1. So just remember, it is not a probability, it is a probability per unit time. So that can be 0 to infinity. Okay. So now we are just giving the four different type of hazard function. It is a constant for the corresponding theoretical distribution. When you use the exponential distribution, your hazard rate is constant. Most of the engineering people are very fond of this exponential and Weber distributions. They are using it. Exponential is this one, constant hazard rate. Weber is having some time increasing, some time decreasing, and a constant. So when your say parameter of Weber distribution is 1, then that will be coincide with a exponential distribution, and you can use that as a constant hazard rate. So your Weber distribution is a distribution that is having an increasing and is increasing and decreasing hazard rate. But see the what about this log normal? See, log normal is sometime increasing, reach up to point, then start decreasing. So hazard function can take any shapes, and that is a very nice thing of the hazard rate. It can take any shape, but from if you are knowing the hazard rate, you can find the survival function, and if you know the survival function, you can find the hazard rate. See, try to understand your situation. You are talking about the survival function, that is a non-increasing function. So whatever the situation, that have to go down a particular direction, but hazard rate has no problem. It may be increasing, it may be decreasing in the same function, it may be increasing for a function, it may be decreasing for a function, it may be constant. So it can take any value. But after transformation corresponding to hazard function, you are going to get a survival function. Now, so we are talking about the relationship of the hazard function and survival function. So survival function can be written as exponential of minus integration from 0 to 2 h of mu of d u, and ht is equal to minus ds of dt divided by ht. इसको मैं जरा एक्सप्लेन कर देता हूं क्योंकि ये कंफ्यूजन करेगा बाद में. ओके, सी, रिमेंबर वेल, when I started my lecture, I just talk about the t, that t should be random. So basically t is a random variable. Whenever you have a random variable, corresponding to this random variable, you can find a distribution function f of t. And this f of t, you can find s of t. This s of t is equal to 1 minus f of t. So in survival analysis, we are starting from here. This f of t, you can find the density function f of t, and this h of t can be defined as f of t divided by s of t, and this corresponding to this one, you can define another function ht, that is integration from 0 to t ht dt. And see, so whenever you use any random variable corresponding to this random variable, you can find five quantities. This is a distribution function. Second one is a survival function. Third is a density function. Fourth is a hazard function. And fifth is a cumulative hazard function. In survival analysis, most of the time we are interested in these two. And when you're talking about the distribution theory, we are interested in the all five. But very important thing that if you know any one of them, you can find the remaining force. Okay, so I am just discussing only these two relations here. So what is the relation? These two relations are here. First two relations is this one, ht and ht having this one. Basically this quantity ds by dt, basically it is a, when you write down dht is equal to 1 minus f of t, that gives you the density function, and then you can get go ahead. So summary of the thing, that whatever up to this point we are talking about the survival time, that t is a survival time, it is a random variable, small t is a specific value of the t, d is 0, 1, it is a variable of the failure of the censorship, corresponding that we get the survival function or survival function, and ht is a hazard function. So we are discuss about the basically five different things, and these five things are the basic of the survival analysis. Okay, so now question is that it is the construction of the problem and why we are doing these things. In the survival analysis, there are three different goals. What is the goals? First goal is to estimate and interpret the survival or hazard function from the survival data. Why I am writing that? Or if you are knowing that survival function, there is, you can find the hazard function. If you know the hazard function, you can find the survival function. First step is that you have to find it or estimate it. Second goal is to compare the survival or the hazard function with other hazard function or survival function. Then third one is to assess the relationship of the explanatory variable of the survival time. This line is very important, that explanatory variables. What is the explanatory variables? In the beginning, when I discuss an example that some people are having a cough and cold problem and they are went to the doctor, some people are get cured in 2 days, some take the 3 days, some take the 5, some of them are taking more than 10 days. My question is, why? same disease is there? Why people are having different time to getting cured? Or why they are having the different survival times? So when I am discussing this problem in the class, the students most of the time giving the examples that that maybe the age difference will be there. Yeah, it is true. If you have a different age, there is chances of getting cure is different. If you are a small child, there is chances are different. If you are a person from 10 year to 25 year, there is chances are different. If you are more than 60 year, there is chances of getting cure is different. Time is required. Required time is different. Okay, so now this is happening. So you are claiming that age is having an effect on your survival time. So now thing is that whenever we are talking about the any age or something that is a having an effect on your survival time, it is a changing your survival time. So those variables are changing your survival times or having an effect on the survival time. That effect may be negative, that effect may be positive. So these type of effects, those variables having the effect on your phenomena or survival time, they are known as the explanatory variables or the covariates. Okay. So when you suppose talking about the ST and we are estimating the ST, suppose we have a two data set. For first data set, I just defined a survival function, estimated a survival function. For the second data, I just fitted the this survival function. Now, goal one, estimate the survival function and interpret. I estimated the survival function by using any method. I will discuss those methods in the later portion of the lecture. So suppose I just got the, it is estimated survival function and it is a another data. So now what is survival function? It means chances of happening event is this one. Chances of survival is decreasing very fast. And here it is almost a constant, and after that it starts falling. So now what I did, I just estimate the survival function and I interpret the survival function. Interpretation is may not be correct up to the mark, but it is for a raw interpretation is okay. So in this one failure rate is more and this one is failure rate is less. Okay, no problem, we just go ahead. Suppose there are two survival functions and we just combine them. So now we are talking about the goal number two, to compare the survivor and the hazard function. So there is some particular treatment is going on. So it is a survival function of the treatment and it is a survival function of the placebo. Placebo means there is a portion of the population of the or the experiment or the group for which we are not providing any medicine or something. When you are going for this clinical trials, in the clinical trials we are talking about two groups. One is a control groups and another is a treatment group. In control group, what we are doing, we are giving them, everyone, the medicine. They are look like that they are getting the medicine, but actually for those groups we are giving in the treatment, they are containing that medicine and other they are not getting anything. They are just getting the empty things. So their survival is different and their survival is different. So what you did, there is two different treatment structure is there and you try to compare this. Okay, suppose there is two medicine in the market and they are claiming that they are equivalent or they are better than to each other. So how can you are going to justify what I did? I will try give the medicine, one medicine to the one group and another medicine to the other group. Find, estimate their survival function and then plot them together. And then just by plotting them together, we can have some idea that this one is better or not. So just not only by the visual, there is mathematical methods is there. So by using those mathematical methods, you can find the which one is better. But I am just talking about very raw terms that you can just plot them and you can just see it. If you have this type of data, there is no problems. Goal three. Usually require the using some form of the mathematical modeling, for example, the Cox proportional hazard approach. अब ये गोल थ्री है, गोल थ्री पे है ये जो गोल, ये रिक्वायर्ड ही क्यों है? पहला जब ये हम कह रहे हैं ना कि इट रिक्वायर्स द सम मैथमेटिकल मॉडलिंग एंड कोवेरिएंट स्टडी, व्हाई इट इज रिक्वायर्ड? वन ऑफ द बेसिक एजम्पशन फॉर द सर्वाइवल एनालिसिस इज द होमोजेनिटी. व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सर्वाइवल एनालिसिस, फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग पीपल्स आर हैविंग वेरी सिंपल एजम्पशंस दैट population is homogeneous and that is always questionable. Why population is homogeneous? I am talking to taking simple question problem. Suppose I am interested in the students are getting job after finishing their final degree. Okay, so all of them are studying from the same group, same college. I am concentrating only to a particular college. Same group, same batch, took the same time of admission. They are studying by in the same place, taught by the same teacher, studying the same syllabus, but they are getting the job at a different point, time of point. Why? First thing, their approach is different. Their hard work means their time of given to the study, that is different, and there may be their background is different. Suppose some students among you is coming from the a particular type of background and he getting the job in the that type of background. So what happened? He is getting some additional help from the background which is not cannot be get by the other students. Okay, suppose some students are having a better quality laptops, they have a better quality of softwares, they have a better relations with the teachers, so they can get a better information or better knowledge or better equipped, or they are getting solve their problems easily. So these type of things, every student is not homogeneous. So when I am talking about the students are getting the job after completion of degree, we are making an assumption that students are same. No, students are not same. So this is the problem that first assumption is that our it is a homogeneity. No, population is not homogeneous. Every individual differs substantially from each other in subsequent to the various disease and the morbidity of the status or in the any phenomena which we are studying. So now question is that if people are different, how we can explain them? Okay, start from the simple things which we can identify. I am talking about the age. Age is irrelevant in this context because students are studying in the same class. The maximum age gap can be 2 years, not more than that. So what can be different? Genders can make a difference. So there is male or female, that may affect the duration positively or negatively. There is chances that females are getting job early, or it may happen that females are not getting the job early. So whatever this data will tell that what is happening, but it can happen. Gender can have effect. Second, what is the financial situation of that person? Same financial situation can affect this result in a two way. Suppose someone is having a lot of money, so he can use that money to improve his skills and in a positive way. In a negative way, that person can say that, okay, I have a lot of money, there is no need to work hard, so I will try for job after some time. So that may affect negatively. So, but we are not sure actually what is happening. Data will tell us. Okay, now we can use a lot of things, but there is still so many reasons which we are not aware. Suppose
I think there is some network issue at Sir's end. Let me just invite him. Huh, sir, you are back. You are back.
Back. Internet hai na aapka jata rehta hai. Okay.
One second. Still visible hai?
Nahin, abhi nahin. It's still loading. Maybe you share, then it will load.
One second. This one, this one. Yeah. Now I have to share it again.
Yes.
Not it's visible.
Yeah, it's visible now.
Then we can just go ahead. So now we're talking about this third one. So no matter how many covariates we want to add, you can add it. It will never be complete one, especially in a case of human. अब इस लाइन का मतलब समझो, आप कितने भी कोवेरिएंट्स ऐड करना चाहते हो, बट यू कैन नॉट फाइनली कंप्लीटेड दिस वन. सो दिस पोर्शन लीड्स टू द सर्वाइवर एनालिसिस टू द अंडर डायमेंशन दैट इज नोन एज द फ्रेल्टी मॉडल्स, एंड वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्कस एनीथिंग अबाउट द फ्रेल्टी मॉडल्स. सो दैट इज अनदर पार्ट ऑफ द सर्वाइवर एनालिसिस. नाउ जस्ट आई जस्ट ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन द what we are trying to say that so one individuals 1 2 3 4 up to n individuals are there. T is their survival times, got the event, and D is the it is censored or not, d1 d2 d3 d4. So this d1 di can take value either 0 or 1. t1 t2 t3 can take any values from 0 to infinity, and now we are giving the x1 x2 and xp are the p different explanatory variables or the covariates. Okay, so suppose I am telling that it is the age, it is the gender, it is the height of the student, and some other phenomena. Whatever, how many numbers of covariates you want to add, you can add it. That is not a problem. Okay, when you add a lot of covariates and after that testing you will find only few of them are the relevant, you can remove another covariates. Okay. Now, so suppose this di can take values either 0 or 1. So when you sum these all di's, so summation of di is varying from 1 to n, that gives you the number of failures. So for how many persons you are going to get the this event occurred, you are going to that number from here. This basically when you are talking about x22 or x2p. We are enter these things in a data sheet and then we perform our results. So first I will show you some examples of the data set and then we just go ahead. Now this is the one second copy. Yeah, suppose I am starting from here. Very simple. It is a library. This library you should install and you download and then install. And some package is also required when you are talking discussing about the survival analysis. This mass you have to upload and then just go ahead. We are talking about this one. Run this. So there is one particular type of data is there. See, we are talking about this data set. So this data is basically a phase 2 single sample clinical trial of the Zoroda and oxyplanetic chemotherapy given before the surgery to the 48 advanced gastric cancer patient with this one node resting. And important survival outcomes of the interest is the progression-free survival, which is the time from the entry into the clinical trials until progression or death, which EVAS comes first. मतलब सिंपल सा आप ऐसे समझो, इन अ रफ वे, सम पीपल्स हैव टू गो टू द सर्जरी फॉर द गैस्ट्रिक कैंसर, बिफोर दैट दे आर गेटिंग अ कीमोथेरेपी, इन कीमोथेरेपी देयर इज चांसेस दैट सम सर्वाइवल इवेंट इज कैन हैपन. सो नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग दिस डेटा. सो दिस डेटा इज अवेलेबल इन द आर. सो वॉट इज इन द फर्स्ट लाइन, आई जस्ट एक्सट्रैक्ट द लाइब्रेरी फ्रॉम दैट लाइब्रेरी. In which library this data is there, and it is a file name. It is shows that this one. So when I write down this one, so time in a week, and delta is this one. So I just written that it is 23 to 27. So whatever data is given in this file, that is I just extracted only from the 23 to 27. Now if I want to see the whole data, I just read only the file name. See, there is total 48 data. So there is a time in the week. It is delta is event is happened or not, 10100110. So basically it is survival time, this one. And what is this? It is a delta. Okay. So now the answer. Dekhiye. In this problem, we are just discuss this line, individual number. It is a corresponding survival time and D. We are not discuss anything regarding covariates. Okay. So then I show you another data set. In that data set, you are going to get some more ideas. So this data set is, which is this one, is next one. No. Okay. We just discuss some other examples. So, yeah, start from here. There is one example is here. This is contains only 6 points. Stage. Onset date, progression and death. So I am just telling you a particular data can be represented in a different way or something. See, this data, it talks about the only different type of stages, in which stage your cancer is there. And then it is when you enter the in the study, when study is started, and then when death is occurred. So basically it is a T1. By using this one, you can find these three, you can find another variable of D, and then just go ahead. Now, we are talking about the third data set. This data set is tell about the advanced, some locally advanced disease, and then the mediastinic disease. So there is some particular type of disease is there, and just I am just showing you the data. I am not interested in this one. See. What I did, I just started only 88 to 95 posted survival data. So grade is poor, mode poor, stage, age group, survival time and status. Status we are talking about 0, 1 and 2. First time you see I use a number more than 1. So when we talking about the 0, 1, 2 and 3. This 0, 1 and 2, 3, these are the basically status. Means some person is died from the cancer, it is 1. Someone is not, some event is happy. When event is happened, it is 1. When event is not happened, it is 0. When some person is died from the other reasons, then it is status is 2. So now, we involve one more status in our system, that person is survived from this one. Event is happened, not happened, or something is happened from the other reasons. अब ये ध्यान से देखो, ये जो था डेटा दिया हुआ this one. अब ये actual डेटा कितना बड़ा है ये देखो, how much big? This is a 14,294 ऑब्जर्वेशंस हैं 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 फाइव डिफरेंट वेरिएबल्स के थ्रू किया गया है. ओके सो नाउ जब हम इसके व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वन सी हियर दिस एज ग्रुप इज अ कोवेरिएट स्टेज इज अ कोवेरिएट एंड दिस ग्रेड इज ऑल्सो अ कोवेरिएट. सो नाउ यू हैव अ डेटा विथ सर्वाइवल टाइम विथ censored status or observed status with three different covariates. So now you start your problems where you get this one gastric data here there is only survival time and your it is DIs are there and then you just go ahead and you find a data with one covariates then we just go ahead and we found the data from the 1, 2 and 3 covariates and survival times and then smoking data. This data is related to about this one. For whenever you studied the data, you have should know the what is the details of the data. So this is basically this data is survivor prostate cancer. Yeah, this one. For the smokers, they quit the smoking or not. So this smoking how effect to their disease and this one see it is 125 data heavy smoker lighter and this is the age group and then next one is this one age group 2 age group 4 why we are talking about these four or five age groups see when we are talking about this one see it's this one ध्यान से देखो इन दिस वन वी आर फर्स्ट एड ओनली दिस सिक्स ऑब्जर्वेशन फ्रॉम द कॉलम नंबर 2 to 8 देयर इज सो मेनी कोवेरिएट्स आर एडेड बट वी आर इंटरेस्टेड ओनली इन 2 to 8 सो वी आर जस्ट गिवन दिस वन व्हेन यू राइट डाउन ओनली दिस वन यू विल फाइंड द ऑल कोवेरिएट्स ओके सो देयर मे बी मोर देन 30 कोवेरिएट्स इज देयर सो यू कैन फाइंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट वन एंड दैट कैन बी यूज्ड सो नाउ there is another data set in this one what we are saying that we are just taking first second third 65th and 71st observation and covariates are second third 16 to 20 and 24 and 47 so in this one what we did we just restrict ourselves to a id numbers and then corresponding only few covariates and when I just show you what should be the full data is this one when you read there is so it is very big data there is so many covariates a lot of things are there so now you have to just go ahead and solve this problem now question is that how we are going to solve this problems so data ho gaya we can understand the data now so this is very simple example that it is a summary US data is there then they are plot the hazard functions from the male and females so if hazard function is this one and corresponding survival function will be of the this form it is for the females and it is for the male see here hazard rate is less so obviously survival function will be more hazard function is more survival function will be less so this is just opposite direction both are going so you can plot them and you can use them now question is that okay now I am just going to explain you some data sets so remission of the data it is for the leukemia patients there are two groups one group is the treatment group and another is the placebo groups so when the experiment is conducted and it is found that for the placebo groups all the events are occurred and for the treatment groups only few treatments are occurred treatment means those people are getting the treatment so they are not remission is happened and when those people are not getting the remission sorry not getting the treatment they are happening the remission problems so it is this one when we are talking about this plus that may be the in remission study and ends but there is no result it may be lost of the follow up it may be the withdrawals with plus sign means any one of things can be happened okay now Group treatment, both are having n is equal to 1. This is the data, this is the 2. So for group 1, failure is 9, censored is 10, and total observation is 21. For group 2, 21 is failure, censored is 0, and total is 20. Now, this is for the group 1. It is a serial number, it is a week, and individual failed when for d is equal to 1, and we are talking about the group. X is a group. So now if we combine the whole data, so for one is coming from the treatment group, another is from the placebo group. So now for only for 9 event is occurred for the group 1, but when we go for the group 2, group 2 is all the individuals having the events. Okay, so now we are interested in finding the survival analysis. So what we are talking, 21% survives greater than or equal to 0 week. 21% survives greater than or equal to 6 week. 17% survives greater than or equal to 7 week. So this calculations helps you to make a structure for the survival function. Okay. So now 6% survives greater than or equal to 23 weeks. So total survival is 9. And then just go ahead. So revision of the data group 2, and then I will come back to this one again. So basic data layout of the understanding of the analysis. So how we have to start? First, we are starting from this one. So ordered failure time. Whenever you write down your data, you just try to make them in the order. Because we are in the bracket, we are written the T0. Means it is 0, T1 means the minimum of the observation, and TK is the maximum of the observation, and other observations are just ordered in the same way. And the corresponding failures, MF is there for M1, M2 corresponding to this one, failure is there. Censored in this interval, it will be there, and risk set corresponding to that one, you will find this. So these things are used to get the survival functions. What we are doing, we are interested in the finding the, our first objective of the survival analysis, estimate the survival function. So now, so this is a very simple calculation. Treatment is there, then they are trying to find the hazard rate, and on the basis of this hazard rate, you can say that for those groups which is placebo, hazard rate is high, means chances of failure is more. Okay. When you plot those things, and then you get this type of survival function, and it is a survival function from the data. See, it is for the treatment group, so survival function is higher, and when it's the placebo, it is survival function is the less. Okay. Now come to the disposition, main problem. So estimation, that is whatever I discussed up to this one. First, I started about the discuss about the problem. In second portion, I describe the data, in which form you are going to get the data, and then question is how to estimate the survival function. There is two approaches. One approach is parametric, and another approach is non-parametric. So, we will discuss parametric, and then we discuss about the non-parametric. If you are talking about the parametric approach, your random variable is t, corresponding to this one, you will assume a survival function s of t. So it will be a function of t with some unknown parameters, and then estimate those parameters theta here, these parameters. So now, when you are using the parametric approach, you have the data, random variable t corresponding to that, you assume some survival function, and then by use that survival function, use the statistical procedure to estimate the parameter. There will be some parameters, and then once you know the parameter, you will get the survival function. I am starting from a very simple one. Suppose s of t, you are defining e to the power minus theta of t. It is equal to, if t is greater than 0, equal to 0. Sorry. Okay, so it is survival function. It is survival function. It is the function. T is the quantity you are getting from the samples. This theta is unknown. So corresponding this one, use any classical method. You just find the method of maximum likelihood. From the survival function, first find the density function f of t that can be obtained by d by dt of f of t. When you solve it, you will get theta e to the power minus theta into t. So this is going to be your, what is this? This is your density function. And then corresponding to the density function, find the log likelihood and use any method of maximum likelihood estimate, method of moment, method of percentile, any method, and you just get estimated value of theta hat. Once you get this theta hat, put this theta hat in this expression, you will get the estimated survival function. And put the values of corresponding t, you will get your plots of this type. This type of plots you are going to get. Now, when we are talking about the parametric approach is a very big thing and it is very difficult. A lot of options is there. Every day you are getting new distribution. So you can just get each and every new distribution and try to solve them, and you fit the same data with the different distributions. So a lot of things is there. Basically, that is your ocean. We are not going to that side. We are coming back to the non-parametric. So suppose I am coming to the one more example. This one is a new. See, suppose if you take, for example, this t can follow the distribution. You can use exponential gamma Wevel log normal Pareto, and then so there is a lot of distribution. Any distribution which range is starting from 0 to 2 to infinity of this form, you can use this distribution, those distribution for modeling of your survival data. And these distributions are sometimes called as the lifetime distributions. Okay, so this one. Now we are coming to the non-parametric approach. Non-parametric approach is that you have a data, and whenever you have a data, basically that data is coming from a random variable. If random variable is there, there will be some probability distribution. And if probability distribution is there, so there should be a distribution function. If there is a distribution function, there will be a survival function. Now you have to find a survival function. Question is that. Problem is that when we are starting the data, from the beginning, I just talk about the sensor data. So I am just starting first with the complete data set. If you have a complete data set, what you are going to get, and then how we are going to find the survival function. Okay. Now this. Suppose if you have a data set, suppose T. T is a data set starting from something to something, it is a data set. Then you have to estimate S hat of T. So this S hat T you have to estimate from here. So first step, sort your t and write down observations in the t1 t2 up to in the form of the t1, and then define a function s hat t, and then calculate probability of capital T is greater than t. So this will be gives you 1 if your t is less than t1. It is equal to some quantity if your t is greater than or equal to t1 but less than t2, and so on. And then if t for the last quantity, if your t is greater than this quantity, then that will going to gives you 0. So you will get a different numbers from here, and then that is going to use up this one. So I am just giving very simple example, illustrative example, then I will go ahead. Okay. Now, suppose T is defined as 2, 3, 5, 4, and 6. Okay, so when you sort it in increasing order, that your observations will be, you can write down 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now you have to define S of T, estimated value of S of T. It is equal to 1 if your T is less than 0. It is equal to t is greater than or equal to 2 but less than 3. So how many observations this one? So when we are talking about ST, basically it is a probability of capital T is greater than T. When I choose any number 2, when I choose it is equal to 2, so how many numbers are greater than or equal to 2? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is 5 divided by total number is 5. It is 3. T is less than 4. Then this gives you 4 by 5. Then it gives you 3 by 5, 2 by 5, 1 by 5, and so on. So corresponding survival function you are getting S2 is equal to 1, S3 is equal to 4 by 5, S4 is equal to 3 by 5, S5 is equal to 2 by 5, and S of 6 you are getting 1 by 5. So you are getting this survival function. What is this? This is basically a estimated survival function. If you are know the estimated survival function, you can find the hazard function, you can just go ahead. So just I am going to do the same thing by using R. Yeah. So I just use the library. I just use this data. This data T is the time data. And this, if you are interested in the time, you just see that this one, what is the time? This is this is a visual. Whatever your data set is here, you just plot the histogram, you are getting, this is your data set. Okay, no problem. Then what you create the survival times, and then, so how many objects are there starting from here? This is the, then it is the time is this one. So there is total number of 23 observations are there. So you use the status, all of them are present. So because all of them complete samples, so all of them is going to be have one. So create a vector which increasing where the survival time is censored or the complete. So here we are saying that all the observations are there, so it is a complete. So due to this reason, I just put all the values equal to 1. So length of the status, it is also 23. So now I just make a data frame. Data frame is basically time and status. So if we want to see the our data set, we can see the our data set. See, this is the data set. It is a time, it is a status. All of them are 1, so means they are events are occur. Then KM. In this one, I just fit the survival function by this one. And then see, this is the event. And then now we are just going, just go ahead. It is survival function. Now what I did, I just plot the this one. So just by this one, I just calculated this cumulative probabilities and just plot this function. So corresponding to this one, for see, this is a non-increasing function. It is a step function. And then what we did, we are not assume any functional form of the distribution, and we just find the survival function of the data. Now, then second method is that when you if you are talking about the uncensored or the complete data, second method is that there is censored data and censored data. When censored data is there, so there is two type of situation is there. Suppose we are talking about, suppose there is some studies going on and we having a data in this form that first individual died at this time, second individual died at this time, third one is having event at this time. So if we have a information regarding the individual by type, there is one situation. There is another situation is that we having the information only that this person event is happened today or tomorrow or in this week. So there is a possibility that we are having the information in the form of the interval, or we having information for the each and every individual. If we have a form of the information in the form of the individual, we can use another method, that is the product limit estimator. Or if we have information in the form of the interval, we can use the actuarial methods. I am not going to discuss these things in the theoretical part. I am just giving the examples how it works. So now, actuarial estimator. So we are interested in the find the estimate the survival function. So just it is a, we define an n number of observations in the 10, and r is a this quantity, and then we discuss then this one. I am not going to discuss in the mathematical portion. See, this is the data. From this data, we calculated the survival function. And this survival function is basically empirical survival, empirical survival function. Okay. So this empirical survival functions helps you to get the idea, and you can just plot this one, this function, and you can get the same type of results is there, which we are getting in the previous one. Okay. Now, just wait 1 minute. Now we are coming to the second portion, second example, the Kaplan-Meier estimate. I just simply run and then I just go ahead. In this survival function, what we say that it is a time of event, it is a risk, and then number of events, this is a 0, 1 or something. See, it is also This is the corresponding status. It is 10101. That shows that the which is observation is occurred and which one is not occurred. Corresponding to this one, see, start from here. It is your time. When you run the time, it is a data. For this data, we find the length of the data. It is 12 observation. Then corresponding status is there. We can find the status. First one is the first three observations or the events have occurred. Fourth one is the sensor. Then next two is occurred. Then again sensor. Then event is happened. Then two was so then remaining two was happened. So this is basically the status. So we have just checked the length of the status, because length of the status cannot be different from the length of the your survival time. So now we just combine them in a data frame. I think all of you know the how to combine the data frame. Then use the library and then find the use this command survival fit. You have to make a data frame and then use this command and then find the summary of this. Okay, so this is summary. This is survival function corresponding standard error, 95% confidence interval from the lower to upper structures. Okay, so now this structure is going on. Now I am just show you similar structure and then there is different data set. So there are different data set. Time is this one, risk is this one, event is this one, and survival time is this one, this one. See, whatever data you have you have to write down combined in the form of the function, that is a time comma sensored, and that you have to make that data file, data frame, use that data frame in this command, and you will get this is a time. Then see, when it is a this one, and for the control it is this one, and then corresponding to come, you just go ahead, you will find the intercept and the treatment terms. If they are fitting the exponential distribution, the corresponding log likelihood is there. And then if we are talking about the Weibull distribution, this is this one, and all the solutions is obtained by the Newton-Raphson procedures and this one. So what I illustrated the last example, this last examples is a combination of the parametric and non-parametric structure. See, when I discuss this portion, starting from here to here, they are talking about the non-parametric structure. They are in no exemption or something. But in the next term, when come to this portion and you are assuming here, when you start to assume that it is follow exponential distribution or Weibull distribution, so same thing is done just by using the parametric procedures also, and then they're giving the corresponding likelihood, this one, likelihood ratio test, Walsh test, this one, and they discuss the about the testing procedures, which we are not discussing here. Okay, so now I think I'm just about to finish. It is this one. Thank you. So I just want to show one more thing, this one. No problem. I'm not explaining that example. Okay.
Sir, kindly share the code and the PPT to the participants.
Okay. If there are any questions that may be asked.
Question.
If there are any questions from sir, then please ask. Contents we will share. As I am doing every day, I will share today also.
Okay, no problem. If you have someone have any discussion or any question, they can just email me. Email me. My email ID and contact number is here. Okay. See, survival analysis is a very big topic.
Yes.
And it is very, very difficult to contain in the all things. So this is my phone number and it is my email ID. So anyone interested, they can call me or contact me anytime.
I can see raised hand of Aarti ma'am. Aarti ma'am, if there is any question, please ask. She's not asking.
Sometimes it happens, man. No problem. By mistake, we just touch the thing.
Yes. Okay, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining us for this session. It was a wonderful session.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you so much,
sir. I can leave?
Yes, sir. You can leave. Thank you so much once again, sir. So I'm ending this session here, and we'll meet at 11:30. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining.